Hey, this is Dan.
And Bob.
From GigaBoots.com, and welcome to our quick play of this again. Bob, yeah, what is this?
This is Nioh. Oh, man. Last Chance Trial. There we go.
Is that the full title of the final game?
No, I think.
Nioh, Last Chance Trial. It's based on a youth... what is it? It's based on a light novel, like everything.
All right.
Hattori Hanzo, huh?
Yeah, he's apparently the one giving me this mission.
Oh, okay. You don't just get to play as him.
No, I was sad.
You were a sad boy.
I was a sad boy when I found out I couldn't be Hattori Hanzo. But yeah, this is the last chance, as that thing says, to play Nioh before release.
Oh, that's why it's called Last Chance Trial. When does Nioh come out?
In February. I think it's early February.
So we're January 21st right now. The demo ends on the 22nd.
Mm-hmm.
I guess technically we're in the 22nd now. Whatever. Either way, it ends near the end of January. But it's coming out in February?
Yep.
So. Futamata! Totomi Province. That is some nice polish on that text.
Yeah, we should probably mention this is awesome. This is running on the PS4 Pro now.
Yes, and this recording is in 1080p. Uploaded in 4K to get YouTube to treat it like a proper video.
But, yeah, this is... We see some new stuff in here.
Like what?
Like, I got a Kasurigama now. Look at this. Yeah.
That's cool.
It's pretty neat.
That is pretty neat. You just hit him with the ball end? Oh, okay. Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah, the light hits are all, like, with the ball, and then the heavy hits are the slashing.
Interesting.
It has some mixed in stuff there, too, but mostly slashing.
So, this is the third beta? Third demo beta thing?
Right. This also added stealth attacks. Oh, whoops. He saw me.
Not that you would know, audience. Is that guy eating that other dude?
No, I think he was just trying to pillage his corpse.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the
you cut his head off.
Yeah, I did.
Was that there before?
Yeah. Okay. It just wasn't in the Japanese demo. We got the very beginning of all this back when they started these.
I see. Do they not do that in Japan?
That probably would get them the Z rating in Japan. They probably want to avoid that.
Oh, yeah. That sounds like a rating you might want to avoid.
They did fix the arrows. So now holding the left trigger pulls up your arrow. And then
right stick aims.
Right stick aims and then R2 shoots.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just like, oh, man. That's logical.
Thank you. That's pretty cool. So this game is still dope as fuck, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
It seems like they actually have taken some things from the beta, like probably customer complaints, to heart and fixed things.
That's neat.
Yeah, I mean...
Glad they did it.
They redid the entire way the skills menu is set up.
Okay, like, I'm a bit befuddled by the structure, so is it just...
It basically just, top of it, select a weapon.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just have a giant pile of things you can learn for it.
Okay, it looks like a flowchart. Do you have to unlock things in that order in order to continue?
You can start at any of these.
Any of the leftmost ones?
Yeah, the leftmost ones are the beginning of each section. Mm-hmm. And then they expand out from there. So you don't need to get like this thing at the very top to keep going.
Okay, gotcha.
They also totally reset up the way skill customization looks. So now there's like a section for universal moves at the top.
Okay.
And as you unlock more moves for different weapons, you can alter them. Like, here I could have Waterfall or Reaper.
Oh,
that sort of thing.
Neat.
It's all very much...
This is insanely intense.
Yes.
Compared to either a Ninja Gaiden or a Dark Souls. Because there's a ton of equipment and a ton of, like, customization.
Right.
That just isn't in either. This is a strange new caliber of this type of action game.
Well...
Also, you might notice this runs smooth as fuck now.
Right.
Which it certainly did not do at a decent resolution before. Yeah. Pro's certainly helping.
I was gonna say, another thing, the stamina system I mentioned before, like, you hit R1 at the end of a combo to, like, stabilize and regain your stamina.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in earlier demos, it was just the light stance that let you do that by doing a dodge. Like, whoops. Now I can't even do it with that because I haven't learned that yet. But I actually, it's just something you can learn for all the stances, so...
Okay.
Dodge, to recover from that. And it's just a matter of, oh, well, you need to find the thing that lets you do that.
I see. That system is still weird.
Yeah, that system is still weird and takes a lot of getting used to.
And its visual representation is still not ideal.
Right.
I mean, I guess the visual representation around your character is more helpful than the bar.
Right.
Once you get used to it, probably.
Yeah, I still find myself mostly just looking at the bar, like, glancing up
to it.
That's
not good.
Yeah, it's not great. All right, what's the time we're going to get him?
I guess it is supposed to be an insanely hard thing to do.
Yeah.
You stabbed that guy in the butt. It's very Tenchu 4 of you.
But yeah, I'm really glad that they added that sort, because it always felt like, well, I can sneak up on these guys, but I really can't get an advantage on them from doing it. I get, like, one extra combo in, and that's not that
great.
Which is
not enough, yeah.
It doesn't feel good.
Whereas so yeah, stealth kills just weren't even there before.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
But yeah, good. Nice.
Oh, jeez.
So I assume the primer you want to watch before you play this game is the history of Japan in 9 minutes. This is very helpful for understanding what's going on, right?
Oh, I always suggest Inuyasha. Should I not do that?
I don't know. You tell me. How many Shikan jewels are in this?
I haven't seen any yet.
Is this entire thing to get one shard?
Probably. Probably is.
So this is an Inuyasha movie.
The Inuyasha movies, they don't even get one shard, Dan. Let's not even pretend.
That's terrible. God, that series. Whatever. Dan's not here to shit on Inuyasha.
Are you sure?
I mean, maybe I was put on this earth to do that, but I'm not in this quick play to do that, at very least.
Anything good in here? Ooh, I like how shiny the top of the box looks.
I mean, I would if there was something bright for it to reflect and not just look really weird. Because it's reflecting the fog that's in the house.
It's true. What other...
Is there a cat in this demo?
There has not been a cat in this demo.
But there was in the beta, right?
There was in the beta, not in the alpha.
And since the beta didn't support the pro, it was a 1080p...
Or maybe
or 720p.
Yeah, sub-1080p cat. It's weird. I don't even...
And this doesn't even have a cat.
Mm-hmm.
So, in the order of catliness, the beta was the best version of this.
Probably.
The final game will probably be even better because it will have a cat. And it will have a 4K mode.
I assume.
They mentioned that. They were talking about how they're going to be cinematic.
There is... that node is available. I just don't have that selected here because I was like, I want to do that 60. That's what feels good.
That is what feels good.
But yeah, there's like mode where it locks it to 30, I believe, and tries to get 4K.
Yeah, I believe that's what they said they were trying to do with that mode. Where's Digital Foundry?
I don't know.
I call to my side, my noble tech geeks. That boulder is too perfect. That boulder was crafted with the Japanese ice pick.
Yes.
Oh. I guess that's happening now.
Yeah, so that killed those dudes.
He shouldn't keep a giant boulder next to the ramp that leads to his friends.
Well, he shouldn't, but I mean, they weren't his friends. They were just some demons.
What is with that thing?
What thing?
That weird gray effect.
The waterfall over there?
No, the thing to the left of the waterfall that's literally gray.
Oh, that's the demon smoke. It shows up.
Oh, it's a boss barrier?
Yeah, it's sort of a boss barrier, but it's really just a demon will pop out of there if I get close to it.
So it's a monster closet.
Kinda. Maybe I should use the musket.
You have a musket?
I have a musket.
Good fucking god! Well, shit. Maybe I'm more interested in this game because that's fucking ridiculous. Is there some DLC I could buy to just give me infinite bullets? Because that would be the most fucking hilarious way to play through this game.
That would be pretty good.
That effect is weird.
Yeah.
Booga booga booga.
Oh jeez, I missed him.
So what's your guy's name again? Is it Renford?
William.
William, yes, okay.
All right, they also have a new spirit in this demo. Let's do it. I got a little rabbit.
Rabbit's cool. You seem to be pissing orange lightning? Gold lightning?
Looks that way.
Oh, I don't have the preview screen up over there. I can't look over there to see what color it's supposed to be. Oh.
Secret treasure.
Secret.
Hey, I am a little overpowered for this because I have done it before, and they're actually... This is the demo with the least amount of content I've seen. It's just after you beat this, it's like, oh, here's hard mode of this level, and there's also this boss fight that's insanely hard that you can go play.
That makes sense, since this is basically the final game.
Right, this is really close to launch, and it's... Yeah.
At least on the Pro here, it is much better quality than the earlier versions.
Right.
Like...
Plus, they're only giving you 2 days. Like, the other demos were...
A week.
Almost a week, if not a full week.
Yeah.
Like, at least 4 days.
Yeah. I feel like one of them was 4 days, and maybe another one was a week, but yeah. I mean, I can see why. So, yeah, this game's just generally improving substantially.
Yeah,
which is... earlier versions. Oh my god, does that thing have, like... Man, that effect is cool. Like, how it was transparent and distorting with the evil energy.
Yeah, it's pretty neat.
That looks a lot better in 1080p, 60 frames per second, as it turns out. So, hey, maybe you own a Pro for this. I'm sure you're thrilled that you have a Pro for
this. I mean, this is definitely one of the games I had in mind when I was like, yeah, I'm gonna want to upgrade. Like, this Final Fantasy and Nier.
How much did that upgrade end up costing you? I know you ended up trading in.
Oh, my God, the Umbrella Demons.
Oh. I think we saw that in one of our other quick plays.
Did we?
I believe so.
I don't remember them actually showing up in early demos.
Oh, they did.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't remember. I want to say it was somewhere around 150 or something.
Okay. So yeah, that's not too bad.
Right.
Like, 150 is not... Like, that's half the cost of a Switch. Which everyone assures me is a fucking bullshit price. I don't know if they're right. considering it's the same price as a PS4 or Slim. And neither has an optical cable, so clearly they're both inferior gaming hardware.
One thing I really appreciated, in an earlier demos, the counterattack actually had a glitch where it would not catch the enemy with the attack on it sometimes. I wish I could find a human enemy to show this off on.
Oh god, that guy. Willy Wonka,
the amazing chocolate dude. Suriyama was actually really good for dealing with this dude because he likes jumping away and being really annoying.
Looked to me there like he liked getting fucked. Because he got fucked and he seemed okay with that.
I guess it kind of looked that way.
Yeah, that's... I don't know. Maybe your save file's hacking the game. I don't... In fact, this game seems really easy, Bob. I don't know why you're playing this dumb game for babies. you should be playing a real game like Dark Souls.
Oh, yeah.
Say, Bob. You want to talk about Dark Souls in relation to this? And maybe draw some comparisons?
Sure. This seems so much deeper combat-wise and makes you deal with Sanma in a much more intricate way that I have to wonder if it will appeal to Dark Souls fans. It might be too much.
When you say deal with stamina in a more intricate way, how do you mean? Like, the way you can actually do something about your stamina?
Right, like in Dark Souls it's a matter of, well, I know I can get this 3-hit combo in, then I'm just gonna have to back off. And that sort of thing, where this is like, no, if you just back off, you're probably going to get hit once and then be on your knees and get screwed.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. It's...
Is it too visceral? It might be too visceral for Dark Souls players. Did you just get health from that?
No, I think that's
already... That's green damage.
Yeah,
okay.
That's green damage because it's wind.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm not sure. It's... I feel like the hardcore sect of Dark Souls fans definitely will be up for it, but then there's the lower grade that's like, oh, I was like playing
the journalist, game. Yes,
the game and getting my friends to help me, and then we usually beat bosses. I don't care that the frame rate's terrible, that sort of thing. Which
I don't know anyone that you could be describing that may also work at GigaBoots.
I mean, not even just him.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes.
The other half of GigaBoots basically fits Bob's description. Not that he said that specifically because of them, he said it more of because that's a large amount of people.
Yeah, no, that's definitely, I see that sort of person where I work frequently.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So coworkers.
Yes.
Coworkers in GigaBoots and abroad. Fun.
Yeah. This is like.
Well, you know, Bob, maybe there's merit to action games where you swing a bunch and then you can't swing anymore, so you run.
I mean, you definitely still have to do that in here.
Yeah. But you have the stamina system.
You do,
which allows you to do anything about it other than run.
I mean, you can do something about it, but really it's just more something you have to manage. Like, it's not something that I feel like lets me attack more. It's something where I'm just like, I have to be worried about this.
Right.
Because if I just back off, I'm not going to regain that stamina fast enough to do anything. Like, because your dodges also take stamina and
that's
that
true.
Sort of stuff. So it's like, you really can get screwed.
Mm. So you would say this is the Dark Soul of action games.
Do I have to say that?
I think you already did. Now, I'm wrong, but I think this, and you can't invalidate that, Bob. Bob, are you worried this game is too Japan for audiences?
I mean, I'm sure there are some people who won't like it because of that, but I feel like that's really not something they should be concerned about. If they want to make something this ridiculously Japanese, then go ahead.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think that'll be too huge a detractor, because a lot of people think samurais are cool and aren't, you know, weebs.
Right. Yeah, I mean, certainly.
And this definitely doesn't have that anime feel to it. This is
very much based on paintings of demons and shit from
right.
Japanese mythology. Like, it's not, here's the dumbest thing we could have done with this monster. It, too, is, I don't know, let's say, an idol. A moe loli idol.
Yeah, it's not that. It is definitely not that.
It's not that. And
you're sitting here using really, like, authentic weaponry and stuff. Yeah, it's neat. Did I buy the move that lets me grab him and pull him over?
No, I didn't.
That's a move, though?
Yeah, that's a move.
Pretty cool.
I wonder if I have enough skill points to buy it. Where was it? Well, I only have one skill point, so I don't think I have enough to buy it anyway. Was there? I feel like there was something else that showed up in here. Oh yeah, the blade grab move is actually something that was just in the demo before, and now it's actually in here under ninjutsu stuff.
Oh, that's cool.
And I was like, that's neat to see.
Stay back. I'll poke your eyes. I got this thing. It'll hurt.
Yeah, I smashed his horns off. That's why he fell over like that.
Oh, okay.
And right now, stamina because of it.
Is there a certain type of attack that's more likely to do that?
Just anything that actually hits his head.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, so if you like pull out your gun and shoot him, they will break.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's pretty neat.
That's really neat. I really wish the Dark Souls games ran a bit better, and yeah, I just, at very least, that would be nice.
Yeah. Part of me kind of wishes this didn't even approach the Dark Soulsian genre, but
I mean, it's nice to have an interesting take on that, but I get what you're saying. In fact, I feel that more than you. You have no idea. There's a reason I only played this for 10 minutes.
Right.
But I mean, I like the idea of it being a giant level. Like, that's the neater part of Dark Souls, that this is just a really large level
right.
that you're traveling through.
I'm almost to the boss, so hold on just one second. We'll see if... I think they'll respawn. I think it will.
Okay.
Just have something else to show. Because there's actually, as you noticed, I haven't even run into the cutscenes.
Is that because there are no cutscenes? Oh, hey.
Yeah, there is that move.
That counterattack.
Yeah, that's the counterattack.
So what did you want to say about that?
That used to miss really frequently.
Yeah, I remember seeing that. I'm not sure if it was in our quick place, but I remember seeing that.
But yeah, now it seems to not be doing that so often, so that's good. Even on disparaging height levels like this, it seemed okay.
Okay.
Which that's... I was... Can I just jump past you? Will you kill me while I'm trying to open this door? You won't finish killing me. There wasn't a cutscene, but the boss fits here, though.
Okay, but this had a cutscene.
This had a cutscene, but nothing else in the beta demo trial had.
Last chance.
Last chance.
Nothing else in the last chance did.
Throw grenades at her.
I like that this has a very interesting style to
yeah,
it. It definitely doesn't look like any other game, actually.
I wonder if they'll tie it into Ninja Gaiden.
That would be awful. like, literally tie the lores together?
Yeah.
Just sink them to the bottom of the ocean? Just do it both at one time, because fuck everything? They're like, yeah, Ninja Gaiden needs to go away for a while, and I'm like, yeah, no, really.
That comment made me sad.
Yeah, it did. That's because you're dumb. You don't get it, Bob. They need more time off. Check this out, Bob. No Ninja Gaiden since 1 should have existed.
It's probably true.
They didn't... Not enough ideas happened in that time span.
Yeah.
That were good.
Yeah.
Even if you combined every idea from 2 and 3.
Yeah.
Just the good ones, it's still like... It's not enough, I don't think. And Ninja Gaiden was an amazing game when it came out. It deserves better. I mean, it deserves this. I'm not saying the sequel to Ninja Gaiden should be this, but you see how Ninja Gaiden for its time is kind of this for this time. Like, it's in a genre that elsewise is not as slick, not as smooth.
That's true,
and
yeah.
It adds a level of polish and coolness to it that it kind of deserves. Admittedly, this isn't quite as visually stunning as Ninja Gaiden was relative to the Xbox library.
True, because that was fucking that was crazy at that time.
You know, back when Japan could do that with hardware. But this, you know, still looks really great. There are only a few effects that make me want to, claw my eyes out. I'm just saying, why don't we live in a perfect world full of proper depth buffers affecting shaders and order-independent transparencies working correctly? It kills me.
Oh, Jesus, that move is ridiculous.
Yeah, it is. It fucked you pretty good.
But yeah, I've always felt kind of like Ninja Gaiden 2 was overrated.
I mean, I'm Dan. My bar for quality on games is absurdly high. Yeah. I still feel like 3 had, like, felt more legitimately a sequel to 1 than 2 did. Because 2 looks so similar. And all of its ideas it throws up front and center are just the shittiest ideas you can have.
Yeah.
Just right out of the gate, it's like, you could chop their limbs off now. And I'm like... Why do you think that's the evolution of this thing? Like, yeah. Even if 3 didn't play out well in the long term of like, oh, it's an uneven package and there's balance issues out the wazoo and the story's incredibly stupid, I still think the ideas it presented up front made it more of a proper sequel, like proper evolution of the series. And that took an entire gen just to do that.
Ding. that's the sound that means it's quickly's over.
That's the sound. I thought that was the Dan's Right sound. What if it was both?
GigaBoots has been brought to you by the remarkable generosity of Nicholas Cameron and Vincent Pover.
And Cywolf.
Go to patreon.com/gigaboots and support GigaBoots today.